Hey guys, this is Primeval, back with part 8 of my DD Let's Play as France going for a cultural victory. So, we've been working on the World's Fair here. We've already reached the minimum hammers required for the silver prize, or the second place prize, of a free social policy. And I've actually overshot it by 52 hammers, so I don't think we'll actually be able to win first prize here. Maybe if we had dedicated all of our cities to production from the beginning, we might have had a chance. But as it is, I've wasted 52 hammers, and I don't want to risk wasting a whole lot more. So let's switch off from the World's Fair here. We can go and try for the Porcelain Tower. Back here, I think I was working on... Well, let's go and grab a caravan so we can send food to Paris. I would go and build another cargo ship if I had more cargo ship options, but as it is, it's only trade with the Polynesians, and I've already got a cargo ship set up for the most profitable trade route. Okay, Troyes, I think we were, working on this Colosseum. Alright, that seems fine. I can go and check on what my spies are up to. They're just establishing surveillance in Lisbon and Kuala Lumpur. So the Iroquois want some salt here. 3 gold per turn. Let's get the 7 gold per turn and open borders for a... Okay, let's just do 7 gold per turn. Open borders here. I accept. Ooh. So I should have taken a shot with that crossbow last turn. But as it is, this is fine. Get another lumber mill going. Maria has made peace with a number of city-states. Okay, so, looking at global politics, the Iroquois are at war with the Assyrians, the Polynesians are at war with the Germany, and they've backstabbed Carthage. The Germans are at war with the Assyrians and the Polynesians. Portugal is at war with me, and they have denounced the Germans, the Austrians, and the Polynesians. The Austrians are at war with Assyria. I'm at war with Carthage, and Assyria is at war with the Iroquois, Germany, and Austria. So all of the AIs have denounced a number of other civs, and many of them, actually all of them, are at war with at least one other civ. So this is what I like to see. It'll stop the AIs from building wonders exclusively and focusing too much on science, as they have to spend some time pumping up military units. So I'm happy with the state of international relations at the moment. Assyria's gone and denounced us, and that's fine, that's normal. Polynesia and Germany have made peace. Let's see, they didn't swap any cities here. And if possible, I would like to capture Carthage here. They probably have a great work or two, and they do have at least one world wonder, as well as a customs house. That'll be nice for gold. I will need some siege weapons, however. So, industrialization. I do want to head up towards archaeology for the Louvre. But grabbing chemistry would also be good. It'll help us grab Carthage and also up our production on the few mines that we have. So we've got two salt mines in each of our cities, sometimes three. So grabbing chemistry will be quite helpful for our production there, since chemistry does increase the yield of mines by one. Okay, the Iroquois are denouncing us, or at least expressing their displeasure with us. Choose production, there's the Colosseum done. We could go get an observatory. A market does make sense. We do have the one source of horses, so a stable's an option. I think it's time to start work on the university. And by the time we're done, we'll be at 7 pop, and we'll be able to employ one or two of those slots. Here we've got another lumber mill finished, and since we do have public schools, or rather scientific theory, the yield from the lumber mills is 3 hammers, which is pretty sweet. Let's see, what else can I do to try to finish the porcelain towers sooner? Suppose let's unemploy an engineer here. That could get us a new citizen sooner. 8 turns, and then that guy can go and maybe work the hill again. 12 turns versus 11 turns. I think I can risk the porcelain tower by a turn. If it gets me a little more growth, I'm happy with that. We do want to get some more production rolling, so I'll set up another lumber mill down here for Paris to work. Okay, so the Iroquois have denounced us. Bismarck wants to buy our silk. Sell that for the full 240. Renewing the salt deal, that's great. So now we have another nice pile of gold, which I think I will go either buy a public school in my next largest city, so that would be Lyon, or invest in some more city-states. So here we've got a decent amount of gold. Let's go for a bank, and perhaps I will go and buy the city-state. So Kuala Lumpur would be 64. If we were to coup, that's a 77% chance. If we go and toss a little money at Kuala Lumpur, say 250, that would improve our odds. Now we've got an 85% chance. Coup success. Great. Then there's Kiev for a little more culture. They just need 32 more influence. So 500. Sure, let's do it. So we're getting the bulk of our culture from city-states, which is great. Our next policy is in 2 turns, and I will go and work my way towards free thought. And over here we may as well finish this farm. And Does Carthage have enough to kill my unit right here? Probably. He's got a whole bunch of long swords, so we should probably pull back here. And we'll go and send food to Paris. I guess we already have that rolling. We'll have to go and change our home city to Troyes and send food from Troyes to Paris. Okay, Hotha wants to re-establish embassies. And the Ferdial, that's fine. Okay, so we've got a promotion on our crossbow, which means he probably took a whole bunch of damage from Carthage's longswords. Alright, so I don't think we would have been able to beat Maria Theresa here, but we do get a free social policy. Let's go and grab humanism, which brings us closer to free thought, and also gets us a 25% boost to great scientist generation. Got a great writer coming soon, and great artist in 11 turns. We have both the national epic and the garden up now, so that does increase our generation of great people points. Next up, let's go and work on an amphitheater or a bank. I do want to get the Hermitage at some point, but we'll wait until we sync up all the other cities with the opera houses before we have to build it in our capital. Just because apart from meeting the requirements to build the Hermitage, and of course as a prerequisite for radio towers, the amphitheater and the opera house aren't really very useful. The bank will be much more useful for me here. Okay, so we barely survived here. But we can also get a lot closer to getting range or logistics. Let's just go and pull back. I think we'll be safe back here, as long as that German worker stays in the way. Or if I want to be really safe, I should pull back to this hill. Get the lumber mill rolling, and go and ship food to Paris. So Paris has a whole bunch of food here, it's still growing. Definitely lock it down. The lumber mill here. We can go and assign delegates for the host. Since city-states now count for votes, we can probably become host here. And excellent. That'll get us another vote. And we might consider trying to push through our religion as the world religion. It will increase tensions with Austria, but it'll also help us spread our religion and get us that tourism boost in the capital. So we've got ourselves the great writer, and we can also go and choose free thought here, which boosts us from 340 beakers per turn to 369. So that's 29 more science per turn there, which is excellent. We'll grab Barrage 3 here as well to try to get us closer towards range or logistics. And let's just go and kill that longsword and hope that we do survive here. A Carthaginian scout, eh? This worker might be in danger then. I really should start churning out some units. bunch of our deals with Hawatha have ended. France is the next host. Excellent. And we do have a great writer who I could use to write a treatise and get me more than halfway to the next policy. And I might do that, maybe not right away. We'll let our culture patron get up a little higher. But as soon as I grab archaeology, I will want to go and unlock exploration so we can start work on the Louvre. Let's also get some more food rolling here. Looks good. Or we'll go and bring this great general down towards Carthage. Now I do have some gold. I could buy a military unit. No, they're all too expensive. So we're just going to have to lose this worker, unfortunately. Let's switch production in our capital over to a crossbow. That is 5 turns. If I wanted to buy a crossbow, that would be 460. Let's see, who can I sell some items to? Horses? Perhaps Polynesia wants horses? No. Germany? Mary Teresa. Alright, so 4 horses for 180. And another 4 horses for another 180.
Grüß Gott.
Assyria. Bismarck. We could sell our furs here. Do I have excess furs? I do not, but I have excess happiness, so let's go and sell the furs to Bismarck here. Okay, so we can go and purchase a crossbow. Next turn. And most surprisingly, this Carthaginian scout did not elect to steal our worker. Maybe he's going to try to pillage our trade route. Let's get that worker away. Go set up another lumber mill, and we can get to work on a chateau or a trading post. Let's go for a trading post here. That's more gold and science. I'd rather have that than the culture at the moment. Okay, and here, try and finish off that longsword. We've discovered industrialization, but we don't appear to have coal within our borders. 1, 2, 3. This coal is fairly close. We could buy the tiles in that direction. There's coal over here. And coal over here. It's a 7 coal. The 3 coal would be enough if we wanted to try to get ourselves an ideology. Do I want to buy my way towards the coal? 85 and 90. Alright, fine, we'll get our own coal online here. And now, do I want to go towards chemistry or archaeology? If I want to hard build factories, then, well, how am I doing tech-wise? I am at the average, only 5% below the tech leader, so I think I can afford to hold off on archaeology and still be able to build the Louvre. In the meantime, go and grab chemistry to A, get the cannon, and B, improve the yields from all of my mines. Since I think we do have a fair chance of taking Carthage here, and it'll definitely be worth it. It'll give us a nice infusion of gold, possibly get us some great works. Alright, so now Carthage is offering us 5 gold per turn for peace. I don't think so. Although our crossbows are being threatened here, let's just go and run away, say, right back to here. We can heal. Get a mine going. Let's steal. Alright, Tereza is only just now entering the industrial era, so that bodes well for us. As far as our textiles go, they are going to be very slow. Let's go and move this guy back to Paris. Maybe we'll catch a spy and get some more experience so we can go and successfully rig or coup some more city-states. Antananarivo, we do have some influence there. If we dropped a city-state or our spy into Cahokia, Cahokia, where are you? Alright, and then tossed a bit of money at them. We could flip them to our side. That would help us out as far as happiness goes. We will be running into our happiness cap by then. And here, let's get to work on that coal. Maria wants all of our cities, that's laughable. No longer friends with Antananarivo. And back to friends status. Okay, this mine will be done in 6 turns. Diplomacy overview. There aren't any AIs that we can buy coal from, so getting our own coal online does make a lot of sense here. Meanwhile, go protect that great general, and we'll bring another crossbowman over towards Carthage. Polynesia wants a research agreement. I don't think so. No thanks. Okay, Assyria has made peace with Germany. And Germany's city-states. We've also got to make peace with Austria. And our puppeted city here has grown. I do want to get some more trading posts here so we can get more gold from that city. Let's push forward to see what's going on down here and sleep the great general. Okay, Bismarck has declared war on Dido. So we might not actually get to Carthage in time to claim it for ourselves. The crossbows are almost healed up, so it's possible. The most literate people were only 2 techs behind the leader now, so that's fantastic. And I probably do want to... we'll try running counterintelligence for a little longer, but I'll eventually try sending a spy back to Assyria, or Assur. I also want to move this warrior towards Carthage in case we get lucky and manage to snipe the city here. We might lose the warrior altogether, but this also gets us a worker. And get some workers. Since this scout is sitting here, we'll just go and bring this worker to build a bunch of trading posts around our puppet.
Es wäre in eurem Interesse.
Okay, selling our marble for a lump sum again. That's great. And here, we'll pillage this and repair it. Got our worker in range. Paris has finished a bank. Let's get to work. We will need the amphitheater eventually, but we also need more happiness, so let's go grab a Colosseum there. And in Lyon, we'll work on the public school. Alright, we've lost ally status with Wittenberg and Manila. Let's go and try to get these back. Toss 500 gold at them. And could perform a coup. We'll wait for the election rig and we might have to toss some extra gold at them before we try to rig the election. Or a coup, rather. Fortify next turn.
Es wäre in eurem Interesse.
Okay, continue buying open borders. And let's get ourselves closer to Carthage here. Okay, there's a trading post done. We can go work on another. And here, that caravan had formerly been going to Colombo. Over here, if we could afford a knight, I would go and buy one here. But I definitely want to run this worker away from that scout. Now, what do I want to do with this caravan? So, Paris as the target city. I am getting as much food as I can. Unfortunately, my puppet city here either is out of range or doesn't have a granary, so it doesn't have a granary, so it can't ship food to Paris. What is my most profitable land-based trade route? Paris to Honolulu, for 13. Alright, let's do that then. So we'll fortify there. This crossbow can go and deal some damage to Carthage. Try and get this crossbow into the fray as well.
Okay.
Let's see how much gold Polynesia will give me for 6 gold per turn. I had sold some gold per turn when I was worried about a backstab, but I think we're happy now. So, I won't worry about that. Okay, Carthage is starting to get a little weaker. Let's go and make sure the city is fully surrounded. Get back on that hill, and here we'll go and resume the very profitable trade route with Honolulu. Our declaration of friendship with Polynesia and Germany has each branch course. Discuss declaration of friendship. Excellent. And discuss declaration of friendship. Excellent. And are we still friends with Austria here? Yes, we are. Do we have excess wine? No, we don't. So I won't be selling that. There, chemistry's done. I could grab fertilizer. But what I really want is to grab archaeology now. And here, we'll go make another trading post. I'll leave the worker there. And this is where we'll end the video. Next turn, we'll find out if we can get Carthage for next to nothing. Yeah, this warrior has really been paying off for us.